number 7, Millie York.
Go, Millie!
A junior defender, number 9, Sarah Miller. A sophomore midfielder, number 10, Amanda Ferry. A senior midfielder, number 11, Sol Baldassini. A senior midfielder, number 17, Casey Hamilton. A sophomore midfielder, number 19, Arachnes Biondar. A junior mid-forward, junior forward number 21, Amanda Bartholomew. And a senior defender number 23, Emily Wilhelm. Bobcats are coached by Hope Clark. She's assisted by Matt Sive and Abby Dalton. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the match.
Oh. Is that good? No.
Oh, no national anthem because we already did one today?
Maybe.
Hello, folks, and welcome to Milledgeville. For some of you, welcome back. We've already had one game today in the 2016 Bobcat Shootout, but now the home team gets to take the field. The Georgia College Bobcats taking on the Blazers of Valdosta State in game number 2 of the Shootout. Our first game today saw Peach Belt Conference member Armstrong State just take it to Anderson University, 4-1 win for them. Valdosta will face Armstrong State on Sunday. Bobcats will see Anderson early on Sunday as well. But Bobcats looking to continue a hot start, 2-0 on the year after two 2-0 wins. Easy enough, right? Hopefully the Bobcats can keep it up. The defenses look sharp so far. And Valdosta heads into town with a couple losses on their plate. Lost to Auburn Montgomery. That was a 1-0 loss, and then a 2-1 loss to Peach Belt member Clayton State just a few days ago. So Valdosta trying to right the ship, and Bobcats looking to continue a great start and out-of-conference play. Sam Jones here with you on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. I'm joined by my partner Riley Williams. And Riley, why don't we go and tell the folks how both teams will line up today?
For the Valdosta State Blazers, we got in goal number 0, Alyssa Curtis. Number 2, Kayla Robles. Number 3, Brittany Benedict. Number 4, Ilaria Burney. Number 5, Riley Tennant. Number 7, Ava Scott Moncrief. Number 9, Subi Savalanian. Number 11, Sabrina Magno. Number 13, Zani Anderson. Number 17, Logan Lindy. And number 26, Aubrey Denton. And for the Georgia College Bobcats, in goal, 00, Jessica Catapano. Number 3, Maddie Steven. Number 6, Elise Schwartz. Number 7, Millie York. 9, Sarah Miller. 10, Amanda Ferry. 11, Sol Baldassini. 17, Casey Hamilton. 19, Raggy John, a daughter.
Good try.
Almost. Dang. 21, Amanda Bartholomew, and 23, Emily Wilhelm.
Very nice job, Riley. Thank you very much. Arachne Theater, Beyond a Daughter.
Oh, that
getting
was
the start.
Oh, I was so
today
wrong.
For the Cats.
I was so wrong.
The Icelandic International. Of course, Bobcats have two of them, and Raggy and Umbjor Golmar's daughter, also on the team. Good start for the Cats so far. Maintaining most possession. Now Valdosta State going to come right back at them. Down the side, Elise Schwartz there to pick things up. The second team all Peach Belt member. Always excellent at the fullback position. She's playing on the left to start this one out. You might see her switch a couple times tonight. We'll have to get her speed out on the wings.
Yes, Sam. Elise Schwartz ended up playing on the right side, actually, in the game that I commentated Saturday. Mm-hmm. She switched back and forth from the left and the right side in the back. So use her talents on both sides of the field.
That one to 2-0 win for the Bobcats over Mount Olive. Just a day later against Newberry, they also won 2-0. So two clean sheets to start the year, which is good news. Bobcats are switching out in between keepers too, which is very interesting. You got Jessica Catapano starting today. Ashley Graham, second team all Peach Belt member last year just as a freshman, is on the bench for the first half. But both have played 90 minutes in two games. Each has traded off a half. So we might see Ashley later today as the Bobcats continue to sort out the keeper position. But now a shot. Right footed just going to clear the crossbar. Raggy taking a swipe at one.
Yes, yeah, Sam, you can hear the crowd getting in behind the Bobcats today as they look forward to winning this one. It was a nice shot there by Raggy. Went just over, like you said, for a goal kick.
Raggy already has one. This year, four separate Bobcats have put the ball in the back of the net. Raleigh Anamashan, Amanda Bartholomew, the transfer from Virginia Commonwealth, and Anya Mancinelli accompany Raggy in that category. But Valdosta State heading the other way.
Is Virginia Commonwealth, are they Division I?
They would be, yes.
That's what I thought.
Not for football or anything like that, but
no.
For every other sport, they would be Division I. One of our other staff members here played against Virginia Commonwealth, often played at St. Bonaventure. Shout out to Reed over on the far side. Over there in the Atlantic 10 Conference. Good basketball conference.
Yes, it is.
41-45 left on the clock as we are early in the first half in Milledgeville. Good defense here from the Cats as the pressing continues. Nice hustle play there from Amanda Ferry, but the Bobcats can't continue the counter. They'll reset as York plays it up the ball to Sini. Now Hamilton looks forward to Amanda Ferry now working up. And the Bobcats will back off. We saw, I believe the final tally ended up being 38 shots.
Yeah.
In the last game?
It was something unbelievable, Sam.
Of course, 31 of those belong to Armstrong State, who was picked second in the PBC. Meanwhile, the Bobcats picked to finish fifth in the Peach Belt Conference after the tournament semifinal appearance. Now I got to do some defending. Millie York tracking over, and the Hove England center back tracks over, and Valdosta wins a corner.
Sam, Millie York has looked very confident this year in the game Saturday and the game Sunday. She played very well with lots of clearances. Very confident back there.
She's very, very steady at the back. Never seems to panic. Corner played in. It's going to find a black shirt poked away by Raggy. They'll go out wide now. It's Scott Moncrief playing the ball in. Finds another black shirt. Bobcats having to panic a little bit here. Cleared away, it bounced back off as Catapano comes out to reach it. Good pressure from Riley Tennant, freshman from Fort Lauderdale, pressing there in the box. Almost found herself with the ball at her feet in an open goal. So the first real excitement of the day is manufactured by the Blazers. Last year, Valdosta, I believe, was 4-14 on the season. And they lost two all-region players as well. So tough loss for them. They do, however, have two players that were voted by the Gulf South Conference coaches as newcomers to watch. Alyssa Curtis, the goalkeeper today for the Blazers, a junior from Palatka, Florida, to transfer from Andrew College. Picked to have a big year for the Blazers after four clean sheets last year for Andrew. This one is up to Steven, who heads it forward. Also a newcomer to watch. Look at Brittany Benedict, freshman from Palm Beach, Florida. Now Bobcats with a chance. Going around his Ferry, right-footed shot deflected. Nice sliding stop there from 26, Aubrey Denton. Bobcats retain possession and win a corner. Nice job, Amanda Bartholomew. Excuse me, I said Ferry. It was Amanda Bartholomew.
There you go. Yeah, Sam, this year Valdosta State is 0-2 so far, only with one goal in the year.
Mm-hmm.
Actually by a freshman who's only played 4 minutes, so she has definitely capitalized her time. That is Megan Muffley. I don't think she is starting today, but look forward to seeing her come in as a sub. It's a Bobcat corner.
Baldassini will take it. They'll play it short. It's Bartholomew. Back to Sol. Low, driven cross, cleared. Roll all the way to the Valdosta bench. Interesting to watch Bartholomew, junior from Peachtree City, Georgia. Of course, like we said, went up to Virginia Commonwealth, has made her way back to the Peach State. And here she goes, some nifty footwork here and a good tackle. Valdosta comes on the counter. Down the wing go the Blazers. I'll slow it up a little bit. A lot of space on the near side right in front of us.
Ooh.
Raggy playing physical.
Yeah, Hilaria Burney still raising her hand, wanting the ball on the near side. And good defense from Sarah Miller as she wins a throw in for the Cats. 37 minutes remaining. Valdosta reclaims possession off the throw in. Casey Hamilton picks up the pieces in a hard line drive that is well behind the lease.
Yeah, Sam, we're going to watch out for Baldassini here in the midfield for the Bobcats. Had impressive games this season so far. She's a great facilitator, looking to send those passes down the wing, maybe for a goal or an assist.
There is Baldassini pushing it forward. The only one up top right now for the Cats is Bartholomew. Billy York heads it down, and that could be trouble. Casey Hamilton having to come over. Now a Valdosta player knocks it backwards. But the Blazers get to reset. It's Robles. In the middle. And Catapano comes out. Coming in from the wing was Larry Burney. Good job from Jessica, the senior, showing her experience there. Headed forward and taken away by Valdosta. Almost 10 minutes gone. Valdosta has looked the more threatening of the two sides so far. Three shots compared to none for the Bobcats. That was a good job from Maddie Steven tracking back. Valdosini tried to get it up the wing to Miller. Sarah's going to have to get back in position quickly. Burney intercepted. Bobcat midfield always very defensive-minded with Hamilton and Baldassini, the two holding midfielders. We'll see Baldassini and Hamilton hold. Meanwhile, Millie York and McWilhelm will stay tight at the center back position. The fullbacks really like to push up, especially Elise, who loves to overlap. Sarah makes a nice play to clear that one out. Good play by Miller. Sabrina Magno, was pushing hard up the far wing. middle of the pitch now are the Blazers, and again, good defense from the two holding midfielders for the Cats. Maddie Steven playing up top today. Of course, last year, she was three-time Peach Belt Defender of the Week. Interesting to see her move to an attacking position.
Yes, Sam, something else I'm looking forward to in this game is the substitution, Sophia Lekas. She definitely gave a spark during the Saturday game that I was here for. She definitely gave the Bobcats a lot of scoring opportunities coming in from on the wing and also just straight ahead on the goal with a couple of shots and a couple of good crosses. So be looking forward to her subbing in sometime during the game to give the Bobcats a little spark.
Lekas is very direct.
Yes, she
goes right for goal almost every time, has a lot of speed, is able to work around defenders, and now Hamilton working around a few defenders, charges forward, and is met by a clump of black shirts. Picked up by Schwartz, who tries to get it out wide to Bartholomew. It's going to be taken away in a hard tackle.
Very clean, ball first.
Ball first, but it looked rough. As number 13, Zani Anderson is up and limping. For Valdosta, she's trying to regain her step. Bobcats took a long time to get that throw in there. Chance for Ferry to make the cross and just miss. Now Miller picking the pieces up, and it's caught and then bobbled a little bit there by the keeper, Curtis. But Miller did a good job of charging in from the right back position. Left-footed shot just right at the keeper.
Puts the Bobcats on the board for shots there.
There's Hamilton again. Ton of tackles already from Baldessini and Hamilton. Out wide to Schwartz, and she couldn't quite find her balance. 32-15 up on the board. Bobcats four shots right now. Valdosta still looking for that first one. Blazers. Playing it around the back, just boot this one forward. Brought down well, and then knocked out of play. It was a good touch from Kayla Robles. Made a bad pass. Here's Sol. So look back towards Millie York in the middle. Now to Hamilton. Schwartz. Nice touch there, but couldn't get back around on it. Good coverage from Zani Anderson. We saw go down earlier. Now Bartholomew moving quickly. Thought about a shot, pulls it back. It's still going to work around the box. Now pulls the cord, and it's blocked. Nice diving stop by Alyssa Curtis as that one looked like it might have skidded towards the bottom left corner.
Yes, yeah, Sam, it's always a good strategy once you're going across to the right side of the field to put it back in the back left corner of the goal. Catches the keeper way off guard, and that's exactly what she did there.
Yeah, you don't necessarily have to hit it too hard as long as you place it in the right spot. And Bartholomew almost fooled her.
Raggy with the corner. Short.
Play it short again. Bartholomew back to Raggy. Cross in. Went far post. Ferry was there, but not quite in the right position. Almost 15 minutes gone.
Yes, Sam, we'll be on the lookout also today for the Blazers. Suvi Savalani, or I'm sorry, I'm butchering that last name. Mm-hmm. But number 9 for the Blazers. She had 3 shots last game, and that was the most on the team, so we'll be looking forward to her putting Catapano to the test here in the first half.
We apologize. We don't have a pronunciation guide for Valdosta, so if we are butchering any of these names, we'll continue to try to do our best here. Bobcats have possession again and is starting to swing a little towards the folks in the white shirts right now as the Cats continue to look threatening in attack. Like we said, 5 shots already through the first 15 minutes. maybe not from the best positions, but so far the Cats have been the better of the two teams.
Whoa, frustration over here from the Bobcat side. Wanting them to push it upfield a little bit.
Bobcats do have a tendency to sit back a little too much and maybe take things a little too slow sometimes. It's part of the strategy, though, for Coach Hope Clark. May not be an exciting one sometimes, but it's effective. 10 wins for the Cats last year. One of the better teams in school history. 2008, 2017 was the only teams to win more than 10 games, and they won 13. Bobcats dispossessed. Ref says play on. Left-footed shot is easily gloved by Katapana. Brittany Benedict with the long attempt there from about 28, 29 yards out.
Yeah, Sam, no real trouble for the keeper there. It just went straight to her. She wasn't really worried about it.
Played back towards the Bobcat half of the field. Got past Miller, but Katapano will play sweeper keeper a little bit and have to pick it up. Swung out wide to Miller.
Sweeper keeper, I like that. I've never heard that before.
Throwing for the Cats right in front of Al Weston, our Georgia College Sports Information Director.
Very lively PA guy over there.
Yeah, absolutely. I wish they could hear him better.
I know.
Through our microphones here. Does a great job. Does a great job at that. And great job as Assistant Athletic Director and Sports Information Director and all the things he does for Bobcat Athletics. Bobcats give away possession here. Bad pass from Millie York. But once again, Sol Bottesini is covering a whole bunch of ground. Her and Casey Hamilton are brick walls right now. Quick throw in for the Cats. Let's see if they move a little quicker here. They have a lot of space. If they just push, they can maybe make something happen. Instead, Hamilton sits back and tries to play a long ball up towards Steven. It's going to get behind her. Shows what I know. Steven cross in. Headed away. That was threatening, though. Awful appetizing from the Cats there. Thank you. 26:45 left. Half number one. Sun's starting to go down in Milledgeville. It's turning into a nice night.
Yeah, it is.
It was hellacious earlier. We were sweating standing up here. Starting to cool down a little bit. This is perfect soccer weather.
I wonder if we'll see any water breaks in this game.
That's a good question. It may not be hot enough anymore to merit it. Bobcats pressing well here. Now some space for Valdosta. Diagonal ball. Lise is going to have to turn her hips quickly. She does a good job. Maybe a foul there. Ref says no. Now out wide to Elise if she can get to it. And here come the Cats. They'll play it back. Baldessini, heavy, heavy touch. And taken away. And Baldessini's going to fight and get it right back. Baldessini, the senior. Argentinian international.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Has played for the U21 team, I believe.
Impressive. Did not know that. Learn something new every day. All right, sounds good. Got a substitution here for Valdosta State. Looks to be like number 16.
Make that number 15. That's going to be Mallory McDaniel.
You're right.
A sophomore from Roswell coming in. She'll play up top.
That looked like a 16.
This number's a little hard to read on there. Bobcats in there. White uniforms with essentially a racing stripe down the left side. Sharp look. Valdosta in the black uniforms with the white and red trim. Up go the Cats. Nice moves here from Raggy, keeping possession, and tried to play it out wide. It'll be taken away. Valdosta. It's Bernie. With a lot of space. Bobcats holding off on pressing her right now. Ooh. Nice footwork there from Savalin. Now out wide. Miller going to have to play some defense. Great cross and almost found the post. Two Valdosta players were on the far post, just couldn't get a foot to it. Thought that one had a chance to sail in on the side netting there. And that would have been a frustrating start for the Cats as Anya Mancinelli comes in. And Amanda Ferry heads off.
Now, Sam, the Bobcats definitely had an outside-inside attack in their game Saturday against Mount Olive.
Mm-hmm.
And if they get back to doing that in this game here, we might see a couple of goal-scoring opportunities because right now they're playing from in to out,
mm-hmm.
and that doesn't create as many opportunities there. So look to see some more wide play from the Bobcats here as we move on through this half with a little under 25 minutes left to go.
The fullbacks have switched, by the way, now for the Cats. Sarah Miller on our near side, Elise Schwartz on the far side.
Got a good crowd turnout here for the Bobcats.
First Friday night game of the year.
Yeah.
This one not deflected by a hurricane.
You're right.
Bobcat Field was underwater, I think, last Friday night.
It's all right. All the students were asleep Saturday, or Friday morning.
That's
so
true.
That was nice.
That's true.
Got some substitutions here for the Bobcats as number three, Maddie Steven goes off along with number 21, Amanda Bartholomew. On is number 27, Sophia Lekas, and number 14, Uno Omer's daughter.
A little more creativity up top now for the Cats as Lekas comes on, and here's a good start as the pressing almost gets her a shot. Putting the ball in the box for Uno. But Lekas, like we said, very direct, a lot of speed, and of course, Ingeborg, very good with the ball at her feet. The sophomore from Iceland.
With the Abby Wambach haircut.
Yes, absolutely.
Nice little ball
there. As Raggy plays one into Ingeborg here.
A little nutmeg from Ingeborg.
Mm-hmm. Anyways, Raggy and Ingeborg, both from Iceland, of course, went to the same, essentially, high school down there. I'm not quite sure how the education system works.
It's called the College of Iceland.
The College of Iceland down there, over there, east of here.
Somewhere
over there.
In the Atlantic Ocean.
Somewhat. Anyways, Ingeborg little, but still awful intimidating. Raggy, on her player bio, was asked to list her biggest fear and simply said Ingeborg. That one knocked away by Valdosta, and hopefully Ingeborg can strike some fear in the back line of Valdosta's. Things continue to stay quiet as we close in on it 20 minutes and 30 seconds up on the board.
Another substitution here for the Bobcats. Out goes Raggy. In comes, who is that? Number 18, Liz Franco.
Liz, a senior from Milton, Georgia, from a Roswell Hornet. Bobcats being very, very patient right now. Maybe now they'll press a little bit. As Mancinelli tries to push it up again. Bobcats playing in to out, like Riley said, and it's not being extremely effective. As they try to get it out to Elise on the wing. Nothing happening. Good defense from Valdosta. And right, Riley said, it just doesn't seem as quite as effective. And I think sometimes the Cats start to rely on moving the ball out wide to Elise. They focus on a little too much, and it hurts them in the long run.
Yeah. It's always easier for midfielder players running down the middle to get a cross coming from the outside, and it's always a lot harder from a keeper standpoint,
mm-hmm.
to guard that situation. So hopefully the Bobcats start realizing that and going outside in.
Here's Ingeborg showing off the wheels a little bit. She'll go out wide. Here's Liz Franco plays a great ball. And Lekas just can't quite keep control of it. But here's Umborg. Gets through one, can't go through the other. There's the most threatening attack of the day from the Bobcats, save for Sarah Miller's strike earlier in the game.
About a touch away from a goal right there.
Mm-hmm. What a ball in from Liz Franco. First off, to pick out Lekas running down the middle, but then to turn her body and whip it in the opposite direction.
It's a great technique.
It was fantastic. Miller finds Uno in the middle. Umborg dancing. Loses possession. Back to Mancinelli now, though. And there it is, out wide to Schwartz. It's not going to work.
Might have hit somebody's car over there.
Throw in for the Cats. Valdosta being kept awfully quiet right now. Which can be a good thing or a bad thing, depending on what kind of person you are. Umborg pops this one up, and a good slide tackle yet again from Valdosta down on the touchline. Corner for the Cats.
Yeah, see, Sam, there's that outside in play. Even if they don't get the ball inside, you still get you create a chance at the corner. So there's the – they started to realize that with the outside, bringing it on in, got a corner out of it. This is Baldassini, yeah?
Yes, it would be.
Taking the corner. Bobcats lined up just outside the 18.
Doesn't look like they have any intentions of going short with this one. They're going to go right into the box. Cross coming in and headed away by Valdosta. Was curling in. Would have been real tough for Alyssa Curtis. Had a Bobcat gotten ahead on it.
Millie York was right there. She was about 5 inches away from getting ahead on that. Another corner. The Bobcats there.
Looks like Sarah Miller will take it.
It's their fourth of the day. Just right about 17 minutes left in the game. In the half.
Ball in again, punched away and almost punched into the net. It slipped off the hand of Curtis just a little bit and deflected off back towards the goal line. Almost found the side netting.
It
that would have been a gift.
Yeah, it definitely looked like that from up here. I don't know how close it was from actually down on the field, though. But
and of course, a lot of bodies around there, too. Tough to get up there and punch the ball when you're getting jostled like that. Another corner coming in. This one a lot easier to handle for Valdosta. And now they'll go the other way if they can get past Baldassini. They won't.
Alicia
being fought off by Baldassini. There, go ahead, Riley.
No, Elise Schwartz directing traffic back there. She was telling them to switch the field. That's exactly what they did. Just a little unfortunate hard pass there. Can't complain, though. Did what you needed to do. Switch the field, create more space.
Ooh, hard hit there. Baldassini went up for a header. No malice in it, just happened to be in the way. Soul jostled a little bit. We'll fix the ponytail. The Bobcats will have a free kick. Soul likes to deliver these free kicks into the box from a long way away.
Still fixing the ponytail.
It's how hard she got hit. The ponytail came loose. So we'll roll it forward. And didn't like how it was set up. Still has to move back. This foul was a lot further back than Sol realized.
Yeah, that ref, the side ref, was telling her to move back there.
Big left foot of Sol Baldassini. Into the box. Franco got a touch. And Bobcats dispossessed. Schwartz will clear it out of play. And Valdosta gets a chance to reset here.
Substitution here for Valdosta State. Out goes number four. In comes number 10. Madison Cutts.
Six shots for the Cats compared to just one for the Blazers. Five corners for Georgia College. and just the one for Valdosta State. In the middle of the park. They'll play it back. They'll probably swing it out wide here. Nope. What a nice turn from Logan Lindy. Now down the far side, back into the middle. And back to Lindy. They'll try it again. Seems like a familiar pattern for the Blazers. We'll see if they can get past Hamilton and Baldessini. They can't. But a good job, a nice tackle to reclaim the ball from Valdosta. Now a chance to get a cross in. Here it comes. It goes a little too far, though. Franco. Nice hustle to get back. And Miller. We'll touch a few times with the hurt. Oh, and a good thought to start the counter from Baldessini. But Franco couldn't get there in time. Pass was just a little bit behind her as well. 13 minutes remaining in half number one. Down to the corner and the cross from Madison Cutts is well wide.
It'll be interesting to see if Catapano stays in the game or if Ashley Graham will come in the second half. We'll have to wait and find out, but Catapano's done a great job so far. And here she is for a goal kick.
Bodies on the floor. Sol went up for one, and now Lekas with some room. Lekas fights off one. She's got Uno, and she won't get there. The thought was there. Umborg had a lot of space. If Lekas had a little more room, she might have been able to play that a little further out wide. But Valdosta was closing in. And maybe not good defense, but lucky defense at least from the Blazers. They've played well from the back all night. Six shots for the Cats, but nothing too threatening. Baldessini. Up towards Franco. Franco back in. Ooh. Bad pass. And Morg has a chance to get it back, and she got a piece of it at least. Cleared away by Valdosta. .30 on the clock. Bobcats tried to get it back in the middle. It was in between two players. Picked up by the Blazers. Up towards Cutts. Or excuse me, Maggie Van Hoosen.
It is definitely cooled off here in Milledgeville for this second game against the Valdosta State Blazers and your own Georgia College Bobcats. Thank you for tuning in here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. It is 0-0, right at 10 minutes, 40 seconds left in the half.
Schwartz having to do some work. Nice stop from her. Valdosta has it back. Miller has to make a clearance. Mishits it a little bit. Took a risk there by trying to boot it away. Had time to bring it down. Waiting in the wings was Madison Cutts. That gets past Miller. Bobcats are in trouble. Back to York. Franco. Forward now, try to get it to Miller. Didn't happen. And a bad pass has the chance for the Bobcats to start a counter, and a long pass. Not going to get to Lekas.
I think she just misread it a little bit there. It looked like Lekas had it on the outside, but she was coming in. And I think she sent it in right as she looked down. So just a little miscommunication there. but nothing that can't be dealt with by the Bobcats. Substitution here for Valdosta State.
For all the patience the Bobcats have in the first two-thirds of the field, it seems like when they get to the final one, they feel like they have to immediately run past three or four people or make a long pass or some other form of, you know, just being in a hurry, it feels like.
Yeah. And
they lose opportunities that way. Like is pressing. When's the throw? Franco grabs it quickly. Sarah Miller. Long pass is taken away. It's Van Hoosen. There's a lot of space. Looks back and gets it. Sonny Anderson now up to Cutts. Cutts. Charging forward, Miller takes her on, and it's a corner for Valdosta.
Nice foot race going on down the sideline right there. It was a good tracking defense by Miller. And it looks like number seven, Ava Scott Moncrief, will take this corner for the Blazers. Millie York stands alone.
We'll play it back to the top of the box. Cross coming in, and it's going to go well over. Ahead of everybody.
Catapano telling her team to push up a little more, try and get some attacking going on after this goal kick. Nice boot.
Picked up by Van Heusen. She'll work her way back in a nice, nifty move. Now a 1-2. She'll get it back to the wing. The cross is very poor.
Oh, I thought that deflected off.
Thought it would have been deflected if it went that far out, but apparently just mishit. Nice little bit of play there.
Yeah.
Though for Van Heusen. And I believe Mallory McDaniel. Can't quite make out the number on that far side. It is Mallory McDaniel. And Lekas. Now Franco. And here's where the Bobcats seem to just hurry up too much. And the spacing widens. Everyone gets a little too far away from each other. It makes passes extremely hard. And you see it again there, an easy clearance for Valdosta as the Bobcats tried to play an extremely long through ball with only one person running towards the back line.
And see, that's the thing, what I was saying earlier and what you said as well, they're playing inside out. You need to play outside where Invorg is right now. You need to play that go-ahead outside and then come around for the inside ball.
Well, here you go, Riley.
Exactly.
As the Bobcats almost had a really nice move through their Invorg, cutting past a few Blazers. 5:40 left in the half as the Cats take a throw in. Now we need to find a double jointed player like Armstrong had.
That was unbelievable.
Game.
That was ridiculous.
We were remarking at one of the Armstrong players' ability to throw the ball about a quarter mile out of a throw in, and we were informed by a parent after the game that the reason she's able to do it is because her shoulders are double jointed. And they act as a whip as she slings the ball in there.
I mean, she was throwing it from almost midfield to the box. I mean, it was unbelievable.
And essentially, it was a corner every time
yeah.
for Armstrong. It was a weapon. We'll talk to Coach Clark after the game.
Get some.
She's got to reshape her recruiting criteria. Cross coming in off the corner, headed away. Hamilton pops it back up. Miller takes a volley, and that could have been interesting.
Not a bad shot there. Just a little more height on that. It might have snuck over the goalkeeper.
So an interesting thought from Sarah Miller. That would have been maybe goal of the year for the Cats if that one had picked up. But it's good to see someone. A little creativity out there on the field right now.
Yeah, Bobcats up 7-2 over Valdosta. Shows the Bobcats got a little more attacking game.
Oh boy, tough play here for Catapano as a couple players collide. Jessica came out there unscathed though.
She just kept going.
Brave from Jessica.
That's what keepers got to do. Just like last game when the keeper from Armstrong went down, she just got right back up, kept going after that injury.
Good job by Wilhelm to match McKay Culberson step for step. As that was almost disastrous for Georgia College. Would have been a rabbit out of the hat for the Blazers.
Yeah, it would have been.
Wilhelm, a lot of room. She can keep going. No pressure on Wilhelm. She tries to play through ball, and it's poor.
Exactly what you're saying is they just seem to get in a hurry when they get past midfield into their attacking third.
Cuts. Continues to work down the touchline. Now cuts in and is giving Sarah Miller a hard job, but Miller's up for it. Good tackle, Sarah Miller.
We got a substitution here. Number 12, Hannah Watkins. Here's his throw in for Valdosta State.
Watkins now the smallest player on the pitch at 5 feet.
Oh my.
Plays up top though.
5 feet, that's, wow.
I'm sure the wheels are there.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
For Miss Watkins. At least the shiftiness that comes with that lower center of gravity.
Like we saw in the previous game, the two Green sisters,
mm-hmm.
They were small, but oh my goodness, they could play.
And now poor communication from the Cats as that one just given away. Miller was hanging back. Wilhelm tried to play it to her, and neither of them really knew exactly what was going on there. Bobcats recovered nicely, though, and here's Baldessini, and another through ball taken away. If you beat it with a hammer long enough, it just might break.
You can hear, you might have heard one of the Bobcat fans saying, relax, and that's exactly what they need to do right now. Oh.
Massanelli goes down hard there.
And she got the header, though. That's all that counts.
Uh-huh. I think her pride was hurt more than anything on that fall. Up quickly, though, is Anya. One of the four Bobcat goal scorers so far on the year. Bobcats would love another one from her right now as we get to the end of the half. 1:15 left in this one. Good clearance from Miller. Picking up by the Blazers.
Ooh.
Montanelli came up, tried to take it away. Tracking back now is Watkins. Plays at the back, under 1 minute. Left in the first half.
We've just seen a lot of back and forth possession here in this last couple minutes. Haven't really got anything going for either team.
Montanelli tried to play a long ball to Liz Franco. Well, over her head.
Ball stopped right on the line.
Seconds, that might have been a handball, nothing called. Now Valdosta has a chance for the final attack of the half. Here's Cutts. She'll work on Emily Wilhelm. Miller was in the center back position though, and the cross a little difficult to handle for Catapano. Had to hop on it twice. And with 10 seconds left, that will probably end the half after the Catapano punt. 1 second left, and that's gonna do it for half number one. Bobcats. 7 shots, and Valdosta with 3, but still no one on the board. We'll see if we can break the deadlock when we come back. We'll be back with you in just a few moments on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Sam Jones, Riley Williams, hope you stay with us, folks. Hello, folks, and welcome back to Milledgeville, now under the lights in beautiful Milledgeville, Georgia. Sam Jones joined by Riley Williams here with you on the Bobcat Broadcast Network, hoping for maybe a more lively second half here as things were awful quiet here in the capital city in half number one. 7 shots for the Cats, 3 shots for Valdosta, 3 shots on target, though, for the Cats so far. And give just 2 shots on target for Valdosta. Halftime just about over, and we're just about ready to go. Go ahead, Rod.
Well, it wasn't necessarily quiet. It was just no goals,
yes,
which is definitely different than the game before this, mm-hmm, against Armstrong and Anderson. Well, there were 5 goals scored in total, and so far there were 38 shots,
mm-hmm,
and so far there has been a total of 9 shots.
Right.
So
maybe we get things pumped up a little bit here.
Yeah. Whoa.
Valdosta trying for a quick start. Well, over the head of a sprinting Kayla Robles. Throwing for Elise. Schwartz, York, Wilhelm, and Miller at the back for the Cats. Bartholomew back in and making her presence felt early. Nice tackle there, and a pass to Raleigh is taken away. Raleigh Anamashan up top for Georgia College, as well as Rackney to their Biana daughter. Put Anya Mancinelli in the middle of the pitch, and of course, the dynamic duo, that pivot with the two holding midfielders of Casey Hamilton and Sol Baldassini.
Yeah, the Bobcats looking to maybe differentiate their attack with Anmashan in there. Hopefully we'll see some fire from her this half. But who knows? It's a Bobcat soccer game. So, well, there may not be a goal scored, but hey,
right,
go Bobcats.
Interesting to see what Raleigh does. Never the speediest cat out there, but always good with the ball at her feet. Very creative, very clever.
And that's what happens. Just like, not necessarily if you're not fast, but if just, mm-hmm, like if you're not skilled in a different way, if you're not fast, if you're not the, mm-hmm, tallest or anything, you always got to have some kind of skill, and it's usually with their feet. So
with her feet, with her work rate, she works really, really hard.
Yeah,
makes up for it in a big way. And that was kind of a threatening attack there from the Cats as Bartholomew was pushing forward. Bartholomew and Raggy have switched out now as Amanda moves up top. Raggy on the left side of the midfield. Good tackle. Well, no, but an illegal tackle. Free kick for Bobcats after Bartholomew commits the foul on Robles. Or for the Blazers, excuse me. Aubrey Denton will take it. Tried to get into the box. It was just short of the box and headed away by the Cats. Good body control from Bjarne Daughter. But Valdosta will reclaim it.
Bjarne Daughter. I got to get that down.
It's a fun thing to say once you got it.
Oh, yeah.
Subi for the Blazers helped facilitate that as they're now working the ball on the far side. Cutting in are the Blazers. Cross coming in, handled very well by Wilhelm. Miller gets it away.
Now, Sam, will this game end in a tie, or will it, if they do tie, will it go into overtime?
I can't remember the out-of-conference rules, but I do believe that they still get overtime out-of-conference.
Right.
It'll be 2, I believe, our 5-minute periods.
All right. Sweet. So maybe we get some free soccer.
Possibly. Possibly.
Possibly.
Sprinting down the side is Bartholomew in a foot race, and she's going to lose it. Good tackle by the Valdosta center and back. It's the first time the Bobcats and Blazers have ever met, which is surprising.
Really?
Both being in-state schools in the Division II level. Bobcats have had a program now for 12 years. It's the 12th year of the program after being started in 2004.
That's only 12 years ago. Wow. 2004.
That one over the goal line, out of touch. And Bjarne Daughter.
Bjarne Daughter. I got it. I'm going to get it.
You got 4 years, right?
Yeah, I got 4 years. I'm hoping to. She's only got three more, but I mean, I'll get it. Nice.
Cross coming in. It's going to be dangerous in front of the goal and somehow cleared away. The ball was floating right over the goal line.
I think Curtis actually got a hand on that, or maybe a body at the end and deflected it out there.
That might have been the best chance the Bobcats have had all night. Good start for the Cats with almost 5 minutes gone in the second.
Miller.
It's going to bounce up in the air. Cluster in front of the goal. Shot going to come in deflected and right to Alyssa Curtis, who almost got caught leaning the other way. Bounced off a defender. Curtis will get to booming away now, though. Nervy moments for the Blazers. But now they get a chance to make up for it. Diagonal ball is headed away and off a Bobcat player. York headed it right in the case of Hamilton, who recovers. And now the Bobcats can push the pace a little bit. No foul as a Bobcat goes to ground. Here's Bartholomew. It's 3-on-5 right now. Bartholomew's going to take it herself. Shot deflected.
It's a tough angle too, Sam. Real,
real tough angle, but still had to make Curtis work, or was able to make Curtis work, rather.
Yeah.
And just for her to get through the massive black shirts there was impressive. Nice job by the Virginia Commonwealth transfer. Big addition for the Cats this year. Corner. Near post. Ooh. And dangerous again. Second time the charm, maybe, for the Cats. Good defense from the Blazers, by the way, there on that one. This one in the middle of the box, taken away by Valdosta. Chance to get out on the break. Nice little deke move there. Well done from Bernie.
Right back to the outside.
Ball in the middle, could be trouble. It curved just enough. If it had stayed flat, it might have gotten to Maggie Van Hoosen, but curled right into the path of Elise Schwartz. And both teams either breaking down defensively or starting to pick it up a little bit on offense. I think it's more on the defensive side of things than anything. But some life in this game.
Yeah, I think both teams are realizing that they really do want to win this game. Mm-hmm. This is the first time get up in the all-time record, you know.
I have just been filling each other out a little bit in that first half. Now things starting to break open. York pushes the ball forward. Valdosta. With the ball in the middle, nice little turn there from Savalainen, whose name I'm sure we're not even close to. Out here, Robles has that one deflected and grabbed by Catapano. Ashley Graham apparently out with a minor injury, nothing to be concerned about. We don't believe, however, we will probably not see Ashley tonight. But it seems that Jessica Catapano is more than up for the task. Valdosta going to play from the back. Boom forward. Elise stayed back on it. Meanwhile, Robles tried to come forward on it. And Elise was able to get it back. But now Valdosta will try it again. Taken away by Raggy. Good defense. Good positioning from her. And now a great ball up towards Bartholomew. Just too far. They're in the most Schwartz. Nice ball up to Raleigh out of Negder. She tried to bring it down with her stomach just about. It skipped low. Couldn't get it. 36 minutes left in regulation.
Almost a cheeky pass there, just a little bit too little on the pass.
Shorts, there's it in. 11 shots now on the board for the Cats and 10 corners.
Wow.
Still nothing to show for it. 10 corners seems remarkable.
I didn't even realize that. It didn't even seem like that many. Oh, I guess that the recent series where they had about three or four in a row.
It was an avalanche.
Yeah.
Corners. Valdosta trying to push it up. Gets past one Bobcat, but Wilhelm was covered. Now Miller pressed forward. Reclaimed by Logan Lindy. And now the Bobcats have it back. Raleigh gonna have to make a decision. Ball played forward to Bartholomew. Too far. It's gonna bounce off and just collide. Good hustle from Bartholomew as the ball was just a little too far, but made Alyssa Curtis work. She had to come out for it, deflected, and almost snuck into the goal.
Got the Bobcat fans here pretty excited on that one. That was the first real threat of the game, seemingly, even though it wasn't actually meant to happen. But hey, we'll take it.
Pushed up. Here's Mancinelli. Out wide to Bartholomew. She tried. I think she was looking for a cross there. No white shirts in the vicinity.
See, that's a good thing that she did right there. The early cross, catching the keeper off guard, because the keeper was still guarding her as if she was going to go all the way down to the baseline to cross it, and it definitely caught the keeper off guard right there. So
she may be able to swing it in just a little bit more.
Yep, yep.
And might have been able to get the feet of Raleigh. But Bartholomew, fun to watch up top.
Yeah, definitely bringing that Division I talent down to the Bobcats, helping them out.
Here's Raleigh out again. Raleigh's having a nice game. Just in the short minutes she's played. Doing a nice job of facilitating. Saw a lot of Bobcat through balls blasted away. But Raleigh has seemed to have a little bit more success. Still nothing to show for it, though.
Looks like she was boxing him out there, just like basketball. Nice use of the head there on a pass. You don't see that very often from York.
Yeah. As Schwartz has it on the wing, she cuts in. Nice job, Elise. Played in, and good defense from Valdosta. Well, that was number 26, Aubrey Denton. Now Mancinelli pressing hard. Fight for the ball. Bobcats want to throw.
Yes, Sam, like you said, Schwartz ends up way up the field more than usual defenders do, and that's good for the Bobcats.
Throwing is headed away, and it's going to be another throw in right next to the stick. Elise will take it. Anima Sean and Bartholomew are the closest. It's to Bartholomew. Cleared away. Counter now, or an attempt at one for Valdosta. Great tackle from Mancinelli, but it comes right to Valdosta player. Ref says play on that. I guess it was a foul from Mancinelli.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. That looked pretty clean.
Now cutting in. Nice move here, but cleared away by York.
Big
boomed into the box. Tried to bring it down with her chest, did Robles. Eventually worked out to Savalinen. Savalinen again. Intercepted by Millie York. Bobcat defense has been stalwart tonight. Amanda Ferry. Bobcats have three players who all have that long brown ponytail and playing the midfield right there. It's Baldessini, Hamilton, and then they had another in Ferry. We played a little bit last year, but we didn't see her too much. But now she's getting more playing time.
Yeah, she played a good bit.
Our job's gotten a little harder.
Yeah. Yeah, Ferry played a good bit in the Mount Olive game.
Mm-hmm.
Did very well. Now, for all the viewers that are watching, when Elise Schwartz makes these runs up the sidelines, you won't notice it, but if you start watching the back left side of the field, you'll see one of the outside players drop back as almost like a fourth defender, replacing Schwartz and the other three moving over. It's a pretty interesting tactic, and it's really good communication by the Bobcats.
It's always been interesting to watch the Cats and just how often they do switch positions. I mean, it really seems to be kind of fluid with how the attacking movement goes and who fills in where. And it's a little more, I guess, dynamic than you would see from other teams. It's slow moving. It's very built on patience and that kind of thing, but everyone kind of has to fill certain roles at certain times.
Yeah. Got a sub for Valdosta State. Number three, Brittany Benedict. And number 10, Madison Cutts, back in for the Blazers.
It's essentially a 4-2-2 right now for the Cats, by the way. With Hamilton and Ferry, the two holding midfielders. Montanelli on the ball. Gets it out wide, and here's a nice turn from Raggy. Raggy's going to get going. Almost got the ball into Animashan, who would still have had some work to do just outside the 18-yard box, but a good thought. Hamilton plays it forward. Long ball up towards Rollyette, headed away. Rollyette going to continue to chase, but Curtis out to snatch it away. 28-30 remaining. In the middle of the field. Who wants it?
Whoa.
Finally just cleared away. Catapano going to have to hustle over to stop this one from going out.
For all you viewers, it has dropped a whopping 10 degrees here. It is now only 85 degrees, which is like winter for
Minnesota. Yeah, pretty much. Only 85 and extremely humid. Here's Bartholomew on the wing. Tried to cut in. She won a corner.
Like Raggy will take the corner as she walks on over to get the ball. Millie York comes up from the defense, see if she can get a head on it. Seems that she's done that just about every corner.
Looks like the Bobcats will go far post. Oh, that cutting in and almost worked out for him. Raleigh going to try to get the ball back, but I thought a whistle blew. Apparently not.
I think he was just a high-pitched fan.
I think so. Coach Hope Clark. In their seventh season in charge of the Cats. Added two new assistants this year, and Matt Sieb. And Bobcat, great. Abby Dalton now. Bartholomew with a chance to shot. What a save. Goodness. Full extension from Melissa Curtis.
You got to give all the credit to Bartholomew right there. She was in midair. I don't know how she got the shot off.
Impressive stuff on both sides, but that save from Curtis, that's one of the best we'll see all year. And shows why she was a player to watch at the beginning of the year for the Gulf South Conference. Impressive stuff.
Now, Sam, Matt Sieb was actually at Valdosta State, wasn't he?
I can't confirm that.
I think he was. I think he was the assistant men's coach.
Okay.
At Valdosta State, if I remember correctly. And actually, he worked for my dad.
Okay.
When he was a freshman at Berry College. So.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, shout out to my dad if he is listening. And go Vikings and go Bobcats.
See, he was an assistant. He was a GA at Valdosta State last year. Absolutely right.
Yeah.
Now the goalkeeper coach, essentially, for the Cats. Bobcats also had former Georgia College great. I didn't get to finish because of Amanda Bartholomew almost making this 1-0.
Yeah.
But Abby Dalton comes in as an assistant. She also spent some time as a trainer here at Georgia College, but now part of the soccer coaching staff after Tina Gallagher leaves to become the Emory Oxford head coach. Just a little bit up 441, then take a left on 20, and you're just about the Emory Oxford.
Yeah. A little substitution for Valdosta State. Number 15, Mallory McDaniel coming in for the Blazers and get the game back going. And Dalton, the assistant coach for the Bobcats, she is actually the all-time assist leader for the women Bobcats here.
I only got to see her play for a year.
Yeah.
But she was excellent from what I saw.
I don't doubt
that. I'm also a big Abby Dalton fan. One time I accidentally cut my head open at work.
Oh, all right.
And was bleeding quite a bit. Abby Dalton was the trainer at the time and just happened to be there and stitched me back up, and I was all good after that. So big shout out to Abby Dalton for that.
Yeah. Go medicine.
Armashan tries to hold it up, but has it taken away. Good pressing here from Raggy, who's been moving the entire time. And look out, folks. About took out the scorer's table over there. As Raggy and Zani Anderson were in a dogfight. 23:45 on the clock. Still 0-0 in Milledgeville.
Both teams looking for the goal that'll give them the upper hand in the game. Bobcats have been the closest so far, but Valdosta, oh.
Poor pass from Millie York. Here comes Valdosta with a 1-2 there. Down the wing goes McDaniel. Cross coming in. Popped up in the air. We'll see if they can clear it away. And Bobcats still got some work to do. Back to McDaniel. Good tackle by Elise Schwartz. Back into the box. Cleared away. I think Wilhelm was there to get ahead on it. Bjarne Daughter gets it back to York, and that's the tensest moment of the half for the Georgia College defense.
Yeah, just a little mistake there by York. Just a misplayed.
Let's see what Bartholomew can do. Gets around one, maybe can get around two. Here comes Bartholomew in a tackle. I think she got the ball. Well done. That was number 26, Aubrey Denton, making the big slide.
A couple of subs here for both teams. Off goes Amanda Ferry. And
all right, let's finish, wait.
Let's see. Wow.
Let's finish.
Oh, and Animashon goes off as well. In comes Baldassini. And in comes Unbjord.
Here's Uno. Popped it forward, was looking for Bartholomew. Gets the ball back, fighting for it. She won't win it back. McDaniel. Tried to push it up. York covering easily. Bobcat defense still remarkable so far today. Only three shots for Valdosta State. I don't believe they've had any in this half. Now here's a chance for one, though. Trying to get the cross in, and they're going to get a cheap corner. No one really near the box for Valdosta.
Looks like Wilhelm got a foot on it.
So now maybe the Blazers can make something of this, their first opportunity of the half.
Stacked up on the back post here.
Ball in, could be trouble, and that almost was. A whole lot of contact there.
Yeah, that could have been bad for the Bobcats.
I think Millie York put a shoulder into somebody. I think I hear a little yelling over there from the Blazer side. They wanted the pin.
Sometimes you just got to let players play, and that's exactly what the referees did there.
Yep. McDaniel continues to find herself with a lot of space. Cut in. Tries to play it out wide, headed away by Miller. Up to Uno. And Uno draws a foul. Up on the clock.
Ooh.
They were looking for Bartholomew on the wing. Didn't happen. McDaniel again. Slide attempt from Bartholomew. He's aggressive.
You hear some of the
Ashley
fans
Miller
over here.
Waiting to throw.
You hear some of the fans over here for the Bobcats. Kind of getting on the ref there, saying they didn't touch it, but it is what it is. Play goes on.
And there's a push. 5-on-5 there. 5-on-5 violence. As Tennant gives a nudge to Mancinelli. Now here's a nice move from the Cats. Baldassini holds play up and sends it backwards. And she lets that one run on. Umbjorg picks it up. Maybe Umbjorg has a chance for a shot. Plays it forward, and Raggy was there, but so were three other Blazers. Umbjorg sprinting all over this final third right now.
Oh, wow. I didn't even see her over there. I thought she was still in the midfield.
Here's Baldassini. Over to Schwartz. Heavy touch from Elise. Reclaims it. Here's Casey Hamilton. Hamilton. Out wide. Popped up in the middle towards Uno, headed away.
Is that outside inside play? Got it, at least got it into the box for the Bobcats. Wow. Big clearance by the Blazers there. Ooh.
Nice little move there from Baldassini, and she tries to play a long ball, and it's not going to do anything. Frustrating right now for the Bobcats in the final third.
They just can't seem to find it. Can't find an open pass down there to create a goal-scoring opportunity.
Their defense, Valdosta, not exactly keen to get forward right now. Neither team looking hyper-threatening. This is a good ball, though. Umborg's going to pick it up. She might take a swipe at it. Oh, and it's deflected.
Wow.
I believe Curtis would have been on it. It was aiming for that bottom left corner. The deflection almost made it worse than it would have been if they just let it go.
Yeah. That could have been bad and accidentally deflected into the goal.
Mm-hmm.
Would have been an own goal for the Blazers.
Here we go, Sol.
Baldassini taking the corner. Bobcats backed up on the back post. York up from the defense.
Near post and can't go in.
Oh, frustrating for the Bobcats.
The ball runs parallel to the line and then gets put back across the frame.
That's 13 shots.
Goodness.
But another corner for the Bobcats, so maybe that'll happen, but it'll go in this time. Here it is.
When will the dam break for Valdosta? And there is a foul on the Cats in the box. Someone says the hey. What was that? I think Bobcats were a little too pushy down there, but I'm sure the fans below us are a little more biased than we are.
Yeah.
Closing in on 15 minutes left in regulation. 13-4 shot difference for the Bobcats. Eight of those shots on target right now for Georgia College.
You would think one of them would just go in one time.
Would be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah. It is a nice switching of the fields for the Bobcats.
Curtis having a great game, as did Bartholomew come from an offside position. No, she didn't, says the assistant referee. Has a chance to work around some people there, but has it knocked out of play. Let's make it 14 corners on the day for Georgia College.
That's crazy.
Ridiculous amount.
More corners than shots. It is Baldassini again with the corner here on the right side of the pitch. Bobcats lined up on the back post. It's a low.
Yeah, that's a poor corner.
Unfortunate.
Soul frustrated with herself.
A little substitution here for the Blazers. Number 4, Laria Burney, and number 23, Maggie Van Hoosen, are back in the game for Valdosta State.
Mancinelli just boots one forward, and now they're going to play it up towards Van Hoosen. She was very effective in her time during the first half. Bobcat's going to have to be careful late in the game.
Raggy definitely thought that went off her. She started running back the other way. Oh, it did go off her. The line judge called it as a Bobcat throw in, but nope.
Mancinelli intercepts one, taken right back by Valdosta on the far side. And the middle taken away again by the Blazers. Far side, it's Burney. Burney, maybe their most threatening player so far. Up now, I think Van Hoosen got a toe on it. Burney and Van Hoosen on that right side. That could be trouble. Umborg almost went spikes up there. That could have been real dangerous. Glad everyone's okay after that. Also, had a chance of being a red card. Schwartz working away around some folks, but has it taken away, and now Bobcats shorthanded. York playing defense, good cross. Oh boy, Catapano had to come out and make a save. Nice job from Mallory McDaniel, who continues to have a solid game on the near side.
Yes, Sam, that was a great example of when Schwartz came up, the back left side, they dropped back and to create another back four there. And, of course, a great save by, or a great, I guess, hauling by Catapano. Not necessarily a save, but here's Bartholomew on the sidelines.
Bartholomew tried to play across him. Instead, it went right at keeper Curtis.
A little under 12 minutes left here to go in the game. Still nil-nil.
Bobcats looking for anything. We've been close a few times. I haven't been able to sneak one over the line, and now a chance for Bartholomew to add some pressure. No foul, says the ref. But here comes Valdosta anyways. And too far.
Ashley Miller just got a little too much foot on that for Valdosta.
Under the 11-minute mark now. Who's going to break this open? Will anyone? With all, they tried to let that one run. Didn't happen. Went out of play instead.
Have another substitution here. We have number 8 in for Valdosta, McKay Culberson. As it is a Valdosta State throw-in.
Thrown over the head of a Valdosta State player. Georgia College will get possession back. Bobcat fans encouraging possession here. You gotta have a little creativity with it too. On the scene, he tried to play it out wide to Miller. Didn't happen.
Played it out west instead.
Under 10. I think far and away tonight, the possibly the most threatening player on the pitch has been Amanda Bartholomew.
Oh, yeah, she is really taking it up that right sideline just all this second half. She has really let that back right back have it, and she has done a great job.
The Bobcats are playing back. Bartholomew is up top. There's no one within 20 yards most of the time, Bartholomew, so they're trying to boom it up to her. Expecting her to hold the play up when she's got four Valdosta players on her. Continue working. Here's a chance, though, as a great ball gets out towards Sarah Miller. Will she get there? No, good clearance. As number 17, Logan Lindy made the play.
That one's going to be hard to find in the woods back there. Substitutions for both teams.
Liz Franco in for the Cats. Well, here's Megan Muffley, by the way, for Valdosta. She has the one goal so far in the year and only 4 minutes of playing time, so Bobcats better watch out. Muffley might be a talisman for them. Here's Schwartz cutting in.
Oh.
Poor ball. She'll get another chance at it, though. This
yes.
one will roll out of play.
If she was just taking one more touch, that might have been a decent ball in right there.
Go with her. Bartholomew tries to work around the defender. Doesn't happen. Here's Elise again. And to Umborg, who thought about getting it to Bartholomew on the first touch.
A little bit under 8 minutes here left to go in the game.
Up to Bartholomew. Needed a pass to Uno and didn't get it. I think Bartholomew thought about the shot. Uno might have had some space if he laid it out for. Slide tackle. Gives the ball right back to Hamilton, who plays a nice ball to Umborg. This one's going to get rolled in the box and be taken away. Valdosta out on the counter. And a foul.
Uh-oh. Looks like a card might be given here to Casey Hamilton.
It's yellow. Hamilton was going to back up and make him run as far as possible before he could hand that card out.
Guards are always funny in soccer.
Maybe if I just sneak away.
They won't see me.
They'll never know. Free kick for the Blazers will be taken by number 25, Ashley Miller. In the middle to Moncrief, or Scott Moncrief, excuse me. Bobcats looking for the late winner. Got a game on Sunday, extra soccer. Won't help the rest time for that. Here's Sophia Lekas for the Cats. And Hannah Watkins on for Valdosta. They're going to get it right to Lekas immediately. Here's Sophia. Nice cut in. Cross is popped up in the air. Who's going to get to it? Montanelli is there. Montanelli tries to turn that one and blast it towards the six-yard box. Doesn't happen.
Yeah, Sam, like we said earlier, Lekas just brings in some kind of offensive spark for the Bobcats just about every time she comes on.
It's a great late sub from Coach Hope Clark. We'll see if it pays off. Watkins gets that one out of the danger zone. Wilhelm over to Miller. Miller just pops it up. It somehow finds the feet of Liz Franco. Not sure if that was the intention, but it worked beautifully. And now Miller goes down. Chance for Valdosta. They have numbers. They look towards the middle, and they pick the one pass they probably shouldn't have made. Still a chance to make something happen, though, as Watkins continues to press. And goodness, there was a lot of space in the middle.
Yeah, there was.
I believe it was number 8, McKay Culberson. He was running wide. Instead, they went for the kill shot. Bobcats handled it easily. Closing in on 5 minutes remaining in regulation. Here's Bartholomew. Nice little turn there. Long shot.
Might have been a handball right there. Oh.
It'll be close, but Mancinelli will get possession back after Valdosta gives it away, and Liz Franco will return the favor. Bartholomew still finding herself with a lot of space as Valdosta starts to push up a little bit more, interestingly enough. Almost looked like they're getting out of shape a little bit.
Wow. Almost.
A throw right next to the corner flag yet again. It's happened a couple times tonight.
That's where they need that Armstrong player.
Throwing to Montanelli in the box. Back to short. She's well covered by Watkins. Watkins is going to have a chance to take off. Ball to Cini there, and they collide. And it's going to be a Bobcat free kick in a good spot.
Wow.
Aldacini just got there first.
It was a hard hit there.
Mm-hmm.
This one didn't knock the ponytail loose this time, though. Ponytail.
Maybe is that's an tight. Omen. We'll see.
Hopefully so. Bobcats are lined up on the back post right outside the 18.
Left foot of Aldacini will swing this one inward. This guy go over the head. Oh, it's off the post. Chance again for the Cats. How close can you be?
Not much closer than that.
Man, oh man. Whatever bad juju the Bobcats have, they need to go to a witch doctor or something and fix this immediately. Goodness, Baldassini gonna try a long shot. Picked up. Well, immediately my first thought was that cross is way too high.
Yeah.
What a poor decision. And then it kept floating and curling and like a butterfly, gently caressed off the side post there. What? And I about threw my paper. Frustrating night at the office, folks. Bartholomew giving chase.
Just right at 2 minutes, 40 seconds left here in the game. With a injured player for the Bobcats. What's that?
That's number 18. That's Liz Franco, who will slowly trot off the field. Rack, Nathan Arbiana daughter comes in her place.
Ooh. Some big bugs up here.
2:36 on the clock. Into the box is Bartholomew cleared away. Jessica Catapano is moving closer and closer towards the midfield lines. The Bobcats continue to press up. It's up towards Bartholomew, and also Raggy was there. Mancinelli was there, excuse me. So close yet again. 10. Sol wins another header. She's had a great night.
Just under 2 minutes here left in the game. But also with a throw in.
Seventeen shots to just four for Valdosta. Bad luck all over the place for the Cats. Lekas, nice first touch. Played up towards Bartholomew cutting in. Tried to make a long run. And a lot of black shirts there, but the Bobcats will pick up the pieces as ball to Sini. Long ball played across. Lekas might get to it. Here we go. Lekas plays it back towards the middle too far. Casey Hamilton is going to try a low shot. Cleared away, but she'll get the ball right back. Automatic ball return for Hamilton. She'll try it again and snagged.
It was on goal, just a little short.
1 minute remaining. Got to move quick now. 50 seconds on the clock.
Oh, come on.
Not quite set. Bobcats are trying to move quickly. When they get this thing off, it'll probably be with about 35 seconds left. As Baldassini waits for the rest of the crowd to get down to the box. We're below 35. Need to hurry a little bit.
30.
Below 30. There's the ball in. It's up towards and caught. Good play from Curtis. Continues to have a good night. Alyssa Curtis, your woman of the match right now for...
Yeah, I don't think you can do that.
Valdosta and a yellow card on the way for Mancinelli. I missed it, Riley.
She basically just jumped in front of the keeper.
Oh, well, yeah, you can't do that.
Nope,
yep.
Nope. I don't think you can do that. But, hey, good effort for that.
The foul stops the clock with 14.4 seconds left. Boomed away. Last chance for everyone here. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and that will end regulation. Well,
is it in the game?
Tough night there for the Bobcats. I believe we will have two overtime periods on the way. 2 5-minute periods on the way between the Bobcats and the Blazers. We'll take a quick break. Back with you for overtime in Milledgeville.
Stay
in
tuned.
Just a moment on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. chance after chance for the Cats to end this one in regulation. Instead, we head to overtime at number one. Your score in Milledgeville still 0-0. Sam Jones with Riley Williams here with you on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Bobcats 19 shots to just 5 for Valdosta State. Stay with us, folks. After the game, we'll get a quick interview, presumably with Coach Hope Clark. We may talk to a player. But stay for the postgame after we finish things up here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Hopefully we finish them soon.
Sleep time.
Bobcat win time, more like it.
Oh, yeah. Now, is this sudden death or golden goal, as many soccer fans know it as? Or...
this one crossed in. I'm trying to remember my Division II college overtime rules here, Riley. I'll get with you in a second on that.
Yeah, you are good. Oh, wow.
And that's just a poor bit of possession there from Baldassini. What's the ball run out of touch?
Come on, Mike. Come on, Mike.
Throw now for Anderson. In the middle, picked up by Mancinelli. He's going to go out wide to Schwartz, who's going to win a foot race. Keeps cutting up and wins a throw in right in front of the Blazer bench. First minute gone in overtime number one. Nice turn from Lucas, or Lekas, excuse me. And it's cleared away though on the cross. Schwartz tries to make a turn, can't get around the defender, Bernie. Bernie goes down. Not sure if it was a throw. I think it's a free kick for Valdosta State. Long ball headed away by York. Taken back by the Blazers. Chip shot. It's going to go wide. First shot in a while for Valdosta. Under 8 minutes left to play in the first overtime. That one off the face of a Blazer player comes back to the feet of the Bobcats. Pushed forward. No one's going to get there. May just not be in the cards for either of these teams tonight.
Yeah.
Few chances on both sides. Nothing's happened. Bobcats have come perilously close a few times. A couple times ran parallel to the goal line.
Yeah, it did. Right across the face of the goal.
We've hit the post. We've seen some remarkable saves from Melissa Curtis. And that's why this one's still 0-0 with 25 shots in the contest.
It's interesting that Lekas got the start for overtime here instead of Bartholomew up top.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they want to start out going fast and just attacking the goal with Lekas' speed.
Long shot attempt, maybe a cross attempt, not really sure. Either way, Catapano has a can of corn. Outside the boot for Miller, almost a nice pass. Got past Raggy, though. Blazers play it in the middle. Robles pops it over to Ava Scott Moncrief in the middle. Schwartz having to do some defending. Plays it up to Mancinelli. There's a whole lot of room in the middle, folks. If she can just see it, there we go. There's Raggy. She tried to play it on the first touch. Maybe shouldn't have. Had room. Mm. Boomed away, and it's going to deflect. This might be a chance for Valdosta, but Elise Schwartz is just too fast. Great recovery from Elise, the All-Peach Belt second team member.
got a substitution for the Bobcats. Out goes Raggy, in comes Maddie Steven.
Moving quickly off the goal kick where the Bobcats almost too quickly. Wilhelm almost ran into the defense.
Oh.
Miller tried the outside of her foot again, and this time just swiped it. Mancinelli still fighting hard. Gotta be careful, it does have a card on her.
Oh yeah, that is true. Forget about those yellow cards sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes they can be pretty big fouls that you may think should be red cards, but sometimes it could just be something as just an unlucky slide tackle.
Mm-hmm.
So.
York blast it forward. Valdosta pretty calm and composed there. Playing kickball right now, folks. Back and forth go the clearances. Miller might just need to run a little bit. Nice ball. If it stays in, will Lekas get to it? No, she won't. So right now, Miller is on the left side, which is not her preferred side. Does not want to use the left boot at all. Is really working to try to use the outstep of her foot on the right side to try to play balls in. And it's not entirely effective right now.
Yeah, we got a substitution here for the Valdosta State Blazers. And it will be Madison Cutts coming in on the left side of the field here.
Mancinelli regains possession. A little bit of a foul there. Ref says play on, nothing doing. Just a nice little bump. Wilhelm has it for Georgia College. York being pressured. Nick Wilhelm. Player lost a shin guard in the middle of the park. Played up towards Bartholomew, and here comes Lekas. Lekas charging forward. Lekas has the ball taken away. Nice play. Aubrey Denton.
Definitely gave the goalkeeper a scare right there. You can see some of the Georgia College fans on the edge of their seats.
Lekas. Fought off a defender. Good play from Anderson. In addition to the good play of Alyssa Curtis, Aubrey Denton's been very good at the back tonight.
Yes, she has.
Anderson puts it forward and off of Bobcat. Nearing 2 minutes to play in the first period of overtime.
Both
teams looking for anything. That one got out of play before it could be punted forward. Good news for Valdosta, too. They get to retain possession.
Bobcats have 5 players back, opposed to their normal 4.
There's Soul, plays the ball forward to Bartholomew. She might have a chance to run another good tackle from Denton.
Bartholomew's down.
Very clean from Denton. Even rocked Bartholomew a little bit. We'll see if she stays in the game. 1:30 left in the period. York brings it down. Pumped forward to Steven. Rough touch.
Bartholomew looks to be okay. She's over there feeling around on her leg, making sure everything's good. But
very, very tough from her.
Yeah.
Space in the middle for Georgia College. And Ballasini tried to loft it over.
Oh.
No one was there. 1 minute left.
1 minute. Less than 1 minute remaining.
Now 19 shots on the goal for for Georgia College, opposed to 7 for Valdosta State.
Quick substitution here with 40 seconds remaining. Anna Michon comes in for Georgia College. Lekas is out.
Now, I think this might be a tactical move by Hope here, giving the players a little more rest time, just kind of running the time off the clock, not trying to really exhaust anybody before the second half of overtime starts.
Well, they may be able to grab a goal here, and oh, there was a good run being made on the other side. Didn't see her. Bobcats keep pushing forward. 14 seconds left. It'll get down to 10. Valdosta going to have the last chance, it looks like. 6 seconds left. Long shot. Catapano was coming up and worried me for just a second. As I thought that might float, there's the end of overtime number one. Nothing happening. And so we'll see what happens in overtime number two, if anything. A lot of fans out here, folks. I'd hate to send them home with a 0-0 draw. Back in just a moment. 3-minute break here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Hope you stay with us, folks. Overtime two kicks off. Bobcats looking for the winner. Valdosta, of course, trying to do the same. Good move on the wing here. Miller made a nice run. Got it over now. Cutting in are the Bobcats and losing possession. Valdosta content to just stay back on this one, I think. Get out of here with a draw, but maybe not as they push forward quickly. One mistake can make this a real bad night for the Cats. But Schwartz, steady at the back. Boom forward, it was number 10. Madison cuts. Goal kick for the Cats, closing in on 9 minutes left in this one.
Catapano telling her Bobcats to get on down the field.
Bobcats trying to move forward. Hope you'll stay with us after the game, folks. Riley's going to go down, have a quick chat with Coach Hope Clark. That'll be live on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. This one played forward. Riley going to charge at it. Cleared away. Maybe the Bobcats can win a corner, and maybe 15th time is the charm.
Maybe so.
This one played, and Stephen was offside.
It's always unfortunate.
Just got caught out of position after the throw. Eight minutes remaining in Milledgeville. We'll also have post-game stats, analysis, and more coming up on the Bobcat Broadcast Network post-game show.
Well, there.
Don't forget, folks, that the Bobcat Shootout continues on Sunday, 12 o'clock. Your Bobcats will take on Anderson University, who dropped a big one today, 4-1 to Armstrong State. Armstrong State will face this Valdosta State team. Armstrong lost their first game, but it looked like a powerhouse today. Great movement off the ball, great speed on the ball. Going to be a tough play for anybody this year.
Oh, yeah.
Be interesting to see how Valdosta handles it.
Right at 7 minutes left here in the game with a Bobcat free kick. We got Raliot up the field along with Steven.
Up to Mancinelli. Too far. Valdosta with space. Out wide. Cutting in now. Back in the middle. And back out wide. McDaniel cutting in. And Baldassini. Or was it Hamilton that got over? It was Hamilton. Making a nice play.
McDaniel with a throw in.
.615 as Catafano scoops it up. Steven heads it forward. Raliot going to get a charge at it. Raliot has some space. Raliot saved.
Just right to the keeper. Very unfortunate. Sam's over here jumping around.
Frustrating right. Night. Baldassini going to have a chance. Raliot again. Saved again! Raliot got taken down by the keeper. No call! No call,
oh,
and it's cleared away.
This is intense, folks.
Anna Michon tried to jump over Curtis.
Oh,
Curtis
my
was
gosh.
Coming up out of her stance. Nothing called there.
Three chances for the Bobcats right there. Could not capitalize, unfortunately.
What a few handful of moments there for Raliot, Anna Michon. Looking for one of the biggest goals, potentially of the year. She tries to play it forward. Steven was making a good run. It was thoughtful, but not executed.
Right at 5 minutes left here in the game. Bobcats pressuring pretty hard alongside Valdosta as they do it right now.
McDaniel back in the middle. Intense moments here at Bobcat Field. Knocked out of play by Anderson.
Bobcats are up 21 shots to 8 shots, along with 14 ridiculous corners to 3.
Anderson Bartholomew on that far side been going at it the last bunch of minutes of this game. Steven has some space on the wing and has played right into the waiting feet of Ashley Miller.
You can tell these girls are getting tired.
Free kick chance for the Cats, closing in on 4 minutes. Clock keeps creeping down. Time running out for Georgia College.
Baldassini here with the free kick. Bobcats on the back post, clustered together. Here it goes. It's high.
It's a good ball. Mancinelli's there. It's deflected. And it might get in. It's on the post again.
With a corner, it ends up being a corner. Oh, it hit the post. What is going on here at Bobcat Field here with 3 minutes and 38 seconds left?
What kind of burial ground is Bobcat Field built on?
I don't know.
There's the real question tonight.
It's up high.
Punched away.
Punched out.
Anamashan was pressing. Bobcats will regain possession. A few black shirts still down on the floor. Time for Baldessini to play a long shot over the crossbar. 3:15 on the clock. Three minutes as Curtis takes her time.
Intense moment for both sides of the game here. Woo.
It is intense to say the least as Anamashan picks the ball back up. Bartholomew doing a good job of controlling everybody. Spirali out with some space is going to have to hold it up forward to Steven. Steven going to move around. Steven towards the goal line and right at the keeper. It was a good thought with Bartholomew coming in. 2:25 on the clock. Did we just see the last chance for the Bobcats? Is there no luck in the cards for Georgia College?
It's been on the Georgia College half of the field most of the game, most of the second half of overtime tonight.
2 minutes. McDaniel taken away. And a poor clearance by Schwartz, who had time, just boomed it forward. Bobcats will get the ball back with about 1:45. Catapano telling her teammates to get forward. Millie York claps him on. Over the head of Mancinelli, it's going to be to Bartholomew. Good job controlling her body, cleared away.
Oh, it's just so close on every level.
And now Valdosta, could they pull one away from the Cats? Into the middle, and the Bobcat defense holds tight again. Excellent job from them tonight.
Approaching a minute left in the game. Bobcats holding possession. Need to push up field.
Baldessini pushes up for Bartholomew, stumbles. She can still press, maybe get a throw out of it. She does. We're under a minute. 55 seconds on the clock. Thrown quickly. Raleigh trying to use her body to shield the defender. Played up towards Steven. Steven trying to get around. Here comes Mancinelli, cleared away. 45 seconds.
Sam, I don't know if they had it.
I think we might be out of time. You never know. 35, long shot! Saved! Oh, what a remarkable strike from the edge there. Was it Miller?
I think it was Bartholomew.
Bartholomew maybe took a swipe at it. Bobcat fans on their feet here. 20 seconds left. Corner coming in. Headed away.
14.
Got to go quickly. And that will most likely do it. 5 seconds. And man, oh man, it's a draw. But it feels like a little more than that as the Bobcats get close time and time again. But can't seem to close it out. Nothing. Your final score after 24 shots from the Cats, 8 from Valdosta State, 3 corners for the Blazers, and 16 for Georgia College. Hope you hang tight with us, folks, as we head towards our post-game show here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Hang around for game stats, as well as our very own Riley Williams giving a post-game interview with Coach Hope Clark. If you're heading out on us, we appreciate you joining us here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. I'm Sam Jones. My partner is Riley Williams, our producer. Well, as Angela Morian doing a great job. Stephen Walters down on the camera, as well as Frankie Hohenstein. Al Weston is the assistant athletic director for Georgia College. Wendell Staten is the athletic director. Thanks so much for listening into us, folks. We'll hope you'll stay around for the Bobcat post-game show interview coming up very, very soon. Again, your final score tonight from Bobcat Field on the West Campus of Georgia College. Bobcats 0, Blazers 0. working on getting those final stats for you. Should be here in just a moment, folks. Whole bunch of chances on the night. Bobcats had a plethora of them. Valdosta had a few here and there. Bobcat defense was stellar as always. That back line might be one of the best, if not the best, in the Southeast. Whole lot of confidence, whole lot of cohesion in that back unit. And of course, a lot of credit to Valdosta State's back line. While there were a lot of chances, when they had to, they made a tackle or slid in front of it. And a ton of credit to Alyssa Curtis, who just might be the player of the game all around. Right now, the live stats showing 14 saves for Curtis. That's just absolutely phenomenal. Meanwhile, on the other side, Catapano, 5 saves for her. And a start for the senior. Again, Ashley Graham out on a minor injury. Don't know when we'll see her back. I think Riley might have a couple questions for Coach Hope about that in a few minutes. Well, as Midnight Train to Georgia plays over the loudspeaker, as is a tradition here, the Bobcats get a big old standing ovation from the Holmes fans tonight for an impressive performance and what really felt like should have been a win. Valdosta State fans on their feet as well for their girls. Both teams played very well tonight. And Coach Hope Clark is trotting over towards the camera. Your final stats tonight, by the way, folks, 24 shots compared to just 8 for Valdosta, 14 on goal for the Bobcats, 5 on goal for Valdosta State. Again, 14 saves for Curtis, 5 for Catapano. 16 corners for Georgia College. Again, nothing coming out of that. 3 corners for Valdosta. 6 fouls for the Blazers, 4 for the Bobcats. 2 players picked up yellow cards in this one. I think we're just about ready to send it down to Riley as Coach Hope gives her daughter a nice big hug. So we're just waiting here in just a second. Send it down to Riley in a few moments. Talk to Coach Hope Clark and her daughter about tonight's nil-nil draw. Again, the Bobcats back in action right here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network on Sunday, September 11th. That'll be at 12 o'clock as the Bobcats take on the Anderson Trojans. Of course, then later in the day, Armstrong State will take on this very same Valdosta State team. What should be a very good out-of-conference game there, and also a preview of the Pirates, who the Bobcats will go down and face in a few weeks down in October. Just a few technical difficulties right now, as is customary for our post-game interview. Wouldn't be a post-game interview without a few glitches. Working it out for you folks, Coach Hope Clark will be on in just a second. Looking at some of the individual stats tonight. Sarah Miller with 3 shots on target. 3 shots. Solbadassini, 4 shots with 1 on target. Amanda Bartholomew, just an absolute terror tonight with 8 shots. 4 of those are on frame. Almost had an incredible strike from about 25 yards out right there at the end. And again, folks, just to talk about a few of the moments, there were corners where the ball would roll right along the frame of the goal. We hit the post twice. There were multiple times where open goals had deflections and just barely went wide. Some great saves by Curtis in goal for the Blazers. And it just wasn't in the cards tonight for the Bobcats. All right, I think we're ready down there. Let's go ahead and send it down to Riley's with Coach Hope Clark.
Hello, this is Riley Williams here with Coach Hope Clark after a tough Bobcat draw with Valdosta State. Coach, first of all, great game. I just got a couple questions here for you. And first off, Catapano played great. And
What's the deal with Ashley Graham? Is she all right? Is she injured?
Yeah, she's actually out right now, so we're just trying to nurse a little injury here. I mean, it's early in the season, and just keep working, but Jess is playing just as well, so we're certainly confident going into the game with Jess.
Yeah, well, also, Coach, Lekas provided amazing offensive support for y'all when she came in, and I was just wondering, will she see a start soon, or...
It's more of a tactical decision. It for me, honestly, starters really don't mean much. It probably means more to the players than it does to me. It's just more of a tactical decision.
Yeah. Cool. Awesome. And also, Bartholomew played great up top today. And I guess you guys, I'll see you guys to continue utilizing her up top to get the ball centered or maybe even score some goals.
Absolutely. I mean, she's a very dynamic player, and her work rate is tremendous, most important.
All right, thanks, Coach. This is Riley Williams here with head coach Hope Clark. A tough draw tonight against the Valdosta State Blazers. Thank you guys for joining the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Riley. Thank you very much, Coach Hope Clark. Again, your final score tonight from Milledgeville, 0-0, as the Bobcats take their first draw of the season. Now 2-0-1 on the year, while Valdosta State moves to 0-2-1. Well, that's going to wrap it up here from Milledgeville. Once again, for Riley Williams, I'm Sam Jones. Big thanks to our producer tonight, Angela Morian, pressing the buttons for us. Hope you have a good night, folks. Stay safe, and go Bobcats.